Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, we have seen some of the very basic understanding of how theming is achieved using Jetpack Compose. In this video, we will specifically look at working with typography. In Jetpack Compose, working with typography involves basically three things. That is, use the default typography types that come with built-in styles. That is, there are around quite a large number of different predefined styles which are defined in the type.kt. And you can use these to work with fonts in your application. This is first way of working with the typography. And here you are not really changing, you are just using the fonts as they are defined in the type.kt. The second way is you modify the default typography with available options. For example, the title large, you want to change it to a cursive style rather than the default style that might be available, which is sans serif. Here you can see that I have defined the title large as font family dot cursive. So I am basically making the title large to be cursive. This is second way of working with the typography. If you are wondering where you will do this modification, you will be doing it in the type.kt file that is available under the ui.theme package. Then there is a third way, which is you can integrate a completely new font family in the application. That is, you download a TTF file and place it in the font folder under the resource, and then you create a completely new font family. So these are the very broadly speaking three main ways in which you work with typography in Android. So let's go through the demo to understand all these three types. So let's start with the first one, which is working with the default typography. So you can see that here, this is South Africa, that is the common name. It has some font family that has been used, which is a sans serif, and there is some text alignment and font size. Instead of using this font family and font size, what you can do is, there is this thing called as style, and then you have material theme dot typography dot say title large. And if you do that, then there is no need to explicitly provide the font family and the font size. You can actually completely remove this. And now if I run this, you should be basically able to see this font family being applied to the common name. I can actually do the same. Come over here, which is capital, remove the font size, and here title small. And now if I run this, you should be able to see a slightly different kind of font than what you were seeing earlier. And if you are wondering how am I being able to refer to this title small, title large, they are basically predefined in the material theme typography class. And if you open the type.kt, there is already a text style that is defined. So instead of title large, I can use body large. And now what will happen is you will start using this font style wherever you use body.large. That is the biggest advantage of defining it in the type.kt and using it everywhere. You can actually see that the font of the common name of the country got slightly modified. I can actually do the same with here as well. That is, let me copy this and official name. Let me remove the font size and let me apply the style and run this. Yeah, this is much better. So this is how you work with the default fonts that are available in the material theme. The other way is you can modify. That is, let me just go here and let me define this title large. Instead of using this font family dot default, I can actually use various other options, that is cursive, default, monospace, serif, sans serif. So let me make it cursive. And what I can do is I can use this title large in case of official name. So instead of body large, I will use title large. And now if I run this, you will see that everywhere, wherever we have used this title large as the font style type, we will start seeing cursive everywhere. That's how easy it is to define new fonts here. So you can see that there are many other things like small label. So as I told, there are quite a number of predefined font types that are there. That is display large, display medium, small, headline, medium, large, small, title, body, label. So you can pretty much define what new font style you want with these things. And then wherever you use title large, that family of the font will get applied there. So we just saw the second way of modifying the font. Now we will look at completely defining our own font type. The first thing we will have to do is we will have to add the TTF file in the resource font folder. So let me go over here, and now under resource, let me create a new folder called as font folder. And under this particular font, what I can do is copy this particular TTF file. So copy. So I have now pasted this TTF file here under the font. And now what I will do is I will create another label large, and then I will create the text style for the label large. So what I will do is font family. And how do you declare the font family? Font family, and then font r.font.ronniswadiarchitect. This is the file that I am referring to. And then you have to define the font weight. You will want to keep it normal. In your real world application, your UI UX team should be able to provide you these TTF files and all the related information, whether it is a normal, bold, all those options. So talk to your UI UX team, and then you can write remaining things. That is font weight is equal to font weight dot normal. You can pretty much do the same thing here. And then now it is time to apply this particular label large. So where shall we use this? So I think this country info app cursive doesn't look good. So let's change that and let's apply label large here. So let me copy this label large and let me go to the scaffold, because that is where this will be present. And in the top app bar, you have country info app, text, then style. And once again, I am going to get it from material theme dot typography dot label large. And we have just defined what this label large means here in the type.kt. So we are pretty good, all set. And let me run this application. You should be able to see the different font family being applied here. Earlier it was taking cursive because we had defined it as title. Now it is taking the label large, and label large is defined here in our type.kt. So yeah, that's it. These are the three ways in which you basically work with the typography in Android. In the next video, we will explore the remaining parts of the theming in Android application.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.